Today I'm in a county where this is the deadliest catch. Don't worry, he's not as vicious as he looks. Not now, anyway. Find out where I am as we escape to the country. On today's show, I'll be helping a leading lady and her scuba-loving husband dive into a new life in a coastal county. And early on, one of our properties leaves them surprisingly lost for words.
You were nearly speechless for a second,
then. Nearly.
I don't do speechless.
Then the mystery house rustles up a real treat.
I love it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Today I'm in Cornwall, and these are Cornish king crabs, or spider crabs. They're native to these seas, and rather tasty, I've been told. Although you'd be hard-pressed to find them as dish of the day on a British menu. Although over 300 tons of spider crabs are caught in Cornish seas every year, around 95% of them are shipped off to the continent, where there's a healthy appetite for them. If you ask me, they're just being shellfish. Well, later on, I'll be trying my hand at fishing for them. But in the meantime, here are some of the other natural delights on offer in this lovely county. Located on the southwestern tip of England, Cornwall is the UK's southernmost county. 80% of Cornwall's borders are coastal, and its rich and varied shoreline spans some 300 miles. The northern stretch, which faces the Atlantic Ocean, is a favourite with surfers, while the southern coastline is more secluded with harbours and fishing villages. Steeped in legend, the county enjoys a rich history. Just on the outskirts of Falmouth, set high upon the headland, is the mighty Pendennis Castle. Built in the early 1540s on the orders of Henry VIII, it stood for five centuries, protecting the British mainland from foreign invaders. When it comes to property prices, Cornwall does carry a small premium, with an average detached house setting you back around £265,000. That's £11,000 above national average. On the coast, you can expect to pay around 25% more, especially if you want a sea view in an attractive fishing village like St Mawes. Lovely. So if it's more bricks for your budget that you're after, the idea is that you move inland. But even here, properties are sought after. So there's a coast and countryside aplenty. And Cornwall isn't short on architectural style either. Attractive fishing villages and scenic harbours are a hallmark of the county. And a waterside property can cost from about £250,000 for a traditional two-bedroom fisherman's carbon slate cottage. Away from the coast, you'll find an array of houses built in local granite. Old miners' and farm workers' cottages, some dating back to the 18th century, are priced at upwards of £360,000 for a four-bedroomed home. But if your budget is more substantial and you've got from around £500,000 to spend, you could be the proud owner of a 17th century granite or stone farmhouse with plenty of land. When it comes to property, Cornwall has something for everyone. But will that be enough for today's buyers? Let's meet them and find out. Angela and Chris have been married for nearly 50 years after meeting on a caravanning holiday. But now they're planning an adventure of a different kind, having spent over 40 years living in the historically industrial town of Altrincham in Cheshire.
We are rather bored with where we're living at the moment, as we've been here for longer than I can remember, really.
40-odd years.
And we've never moved out of the same telephone areas.
For our final fling, we want to go way away and go to the countryside. We think now it would be a fabulous time. Chris has agreed to retire at long last.
Reluctantly, of course, but there you go.
So, with a little bit of arm twisting from Angela, Chris has finally finished working, and now they're both ready to begin the next chapter of their lives together.
We're really looking forward to a different lifestyle and definitely more green.
Chris is a keen scuba diver, and with some of the best diving in the UK around the Cornish coast, they've decided it's the perfect county for their move.
In the north of England, I dive in rather dark quarries, sometimes the temperature's as low as 3 degrees. So understandably, I'm really looking forward to going to Cornwall and diving in seawater.
As for Angela, it's amateur dramatics that floats her boat. And she's hoping that her love of the stage can continue, as she's in no hurry to give up treading the boards.
I started off at my little church. I was playing the Virgin Mary when I was about 11 years old. I've just had a ball. I've loved it. And now I'm doing a bit of directing. Now I'm an older lady, because you don't get the parts when you're an older lady.
Having decided to make the biggest move of their lives to Cornwall, they've got a good budget set aside to make it happen.
Our budget for the property will be looking in the region of £370,000. We could go a little bit further than that if we found something really special.
Chris and Angela would like us to focus our search in the villages near to the cathedral city of Truro. I caught up with them in the beautiful Cornish countryside to find out what our very colourful couple are after. Hey, how are you? Nice to see you.
Hello.
Welcome to Cornwall. OK, let's talk about what you're after then. Ideal house.
Well.
That's a good start.
We're not that bothered, really, about the type of house.
Okay.
It can be anything from a cottage or a barn or anything, really. We'd like a dining kitchen.
Okay.
A decent sitting room with the possibility to have a wood-burning stove.
Right.
You've got two around here, haven't you?
I suppose
you?
So, yeah.
Three bedrooms at least, garden.
Right. This list is getting longer and longer.
Yes, I know, but most of all, a view.
Okay.
Got to have views.
And who's the boss in the relationship?
Oh, come on.
OK. Right. I think we're going to have a bit of trouble here, aren't we?
No, not at all, actually. No.
OK.
46 years, I'm used to it.
Yeah, I'm not. Well, listen, as always, we've got three lovely properties to show you. Well, I think they're lovely anyway.
Oh,
shall we get going?
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Go on, let's hit the road.
Fab.
Okay.
Thank you.
Chris and Angela have a budget of £370,000 to find an idyllic Cornish retreat. They'd like a minimum of three bedrooms, a garden big enough for flower beds and a vegetable patch, a garage, an edge of village location, and fabulous country views. We found three fantastic properties for our buyers to view, but before I reveal the price of each, I'll be asking them to take a guess at it first. The final choice is our mystery house, a property they may not have looked at on paper, but which might just win their hearts. We're starting our journey in the village of Carnan Downs, which is around 3 miles southwest of Truro. This rural location may be small, but it has everything our buyers will need right on their doorstep, including a post office, a shop, a chapel, village hall, and regular bus connections to Truro. Our first house is a charming detached cottage, situated at the top of a long, sweeping driveway.
Oh,
yes.
That's pretty.
Isn't it, Jess?
Yes, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
It was originally a miner's cottage.
Oh.
It dates back to 1850.
Right.
It was a one-up, one-down, and then this L-shaped extension was put on about 15 years ago.
Oh, that's really
God.
Pretty.
You like it?
Yes,
yes,
yes
I do. It looks very sweet.
What about you, Chris? You're going a bit quiet.
Yeah, no, I'm just looking at it.
It doesn't really matter what you think, because she's the boss anyway, doesn't
yeah.
she? So as long as you're saying all the right things, that's brilliant.
Yeah, I'm easily pleased. Sure
I like you
noticed.
So much.
Yes. No,
tell you what,
no.
I feel like swapping places.
Yes. Go on then, yeah. Okay.
We'll go and do a tour.
Yeah.
Anyway, from outside, you like it?
Love
yes,
it. Very
yes,
much.
It's really nice. Can we have a look?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. That's why we're here. Come
yeah.
on. Chris and Angela can't wait to see more of this property. Let's hope it lives up to their expectations when we get inside. So, you're ready for this? Come on in.
Oh.
Don't be shy. What do you think?
I think it's very sweet.
Oh,
it's lovely.
Yes.
Yeah.
It is, isn't it? You wanted a kitchen breakfast room.
Eating
yeah.
kitchen,
got
yes.
quite a big table there.
Yes, it's
yes.
not bad at all.
Quite
is
yeah.
that a range,
yeah, it
Jesse?
Is. Yep.
Very nice.
Yep.
Oil fire, doesn't it?
Quite like this. A larder.
Oh,
some
that's
larder cupboard. Yeah.
Very, very
neat, isn't
good.
It?
Very good.
There are lots
yes.
of little neat touches.
Yes. Not bad at all.
You've also got a massive utility room
oh,
through
great.
There, which you can explore later on.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, really, really good size.
Uh-huh.
Yes, I
good.
Like it.
Shall we have a look at the living room?
Oh, yes,
oh, yes.
please.
Come on then, follow me. This is the living room.
Oh, yes, yes.
I like that.
That's a wood burner and a half.
That's terrific.
Isn't it?
That's something we've discussed before. That was what we wanted.
Yes.
Also, off this living space, you've got two bedrooms.
Oh, that's ideal.
And also, running the whole length of the living room plus some is a conservatory as well.
With that south-facing garden.
Oh, yeah.
But this is very pretty.
Okay, well, let's head upstairs. I'll lead the way.
Thank you.
This floor also has a good-sized family bathroom, but we'll continue our tour in the main bedroom. But come on through to the master.
Ah.
Oh, I haven't seen that face so far. What does that face say?
It's a bit small.
Okay.
A bit small. It's very pretty.
And there is some cupboard in
there. Oh, yeah, there's lots of storage. All this slides back.
Oh, that's not so bad, really.
See, that's what's made the room smaller, isn't it?
I guess so. Yeah. Yes, it's just... But it's going to be, isn't it? It's a cottage.
I think it's very nice.
It's very pretty. The whole thing. They've done it very prettily, I think.
While the mood has taken a bit of a dip, which is a real shame, on this floor, there's one more bedroom, which is a charming single with a lovely ornate window overlooking the garden, which is what we're going to see next. Nice garden, isn't it?
Oh, it's beautiful. It really is.
It's lovely.
You've got the greenhouse there ready to go.
Uh-huh.
And plenty of space to grow your veg as well.
Yes.
And it's manageable.
Yeah, it is.
It is.
It's not too big, but it's plenty big enough.
And you've got the nice cobbled area where you can have your seating.
Nice sitting area, eating area.
Yeah.
On foot stool.
Yes.
This part of it's tremendous. You know, there's even an outdoor barbecue.
And you've got a little room there with a Saniflow loo as well. An office in there if you wanted.
No, an outside loo, huh?
Yeah. So, what do you think?
It's very pretty and it's got a lot going for it, but I'm not too sure.
Okay.
Love the garden. Got to say, this actually is exactly what I would want.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay. Wow. That's great. Should we talk money?
Oh.
This would be interesting, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it will.
You've got £370,000 to play around with, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, what do you reckon this is on the market for?
I'd say £350,000.
£350,000. Okay.
I would think more. I'd think maybe £365,000.
£365,000. Which would only give you £5,000 to play around with, wouldn't it?
It would, yeah.
And it's currently on the market for £325,000.
Well, that's more interesting.
Isn't it? So, you know.
At least we'd have something to spend.
A lot to spend?
Uh-huh. Well, in that case, we'll think about it.
You need to go and have a look upstairs again, don't you?
We do.
I think so, yeah.
Well, listen, these are big decisions, so I think you should go back upstairs, have a good look around and... I'll meet you outside.
Okay.
I'll see you in a bit.
Right, cheers.
This old miner's cottage is on the market for £325,000, well under Chris and Angela's top budget. All in all, it has a lovely kitchen diner, a good-sized utility room, four bedrooms, a bright conservatory, and a perfect-sized garden.
This is the other bedroom onto the main one.
There again, it is rather small, but...
If we were to take that wall out...
Maybe.
We could put an ensuite at this end, and you'd have a big bedroom.
The first house is... It's interesting and very pretty. I like the downstairs. I'm finding the upstairs a little small.
This first house has been interesting because it is exactly what we expected from a cottage. We've always had a slight reservation about the size of the rooms. However, I think there is a possible to correct that with money.
Ah.
Hi.
Hatched a few plans?
I think it needs a bit of thinking about.
OK, you've got plenty of time. I'll do the driving. You two can think in the back.
OK.
OK.
Cornwall is reputed to be one of the warmest and sunniest counties in the UK. The balmy weather not only makes it an appealing option for a holiday, but it's also created an ideal climate for a number of botanical gardens. One such fine example is the Lost Gardens of Heligan. These gardens were hidden from sight for nearly 70 years, but a chance discovery in 1990 has allowed them to be restored to their former glory. Earlier in the week, we arranged for our keen gardeners, Chris and Angela, to meet Mike Friend, the curator, to see some of the horticultural highlights.
How did they manage to lose a garden of this size?
So, well, I mean, it basically comes down to the fact that back in its heyday, the garden staff, most of them went off to fight in the Great War, in the First World War, and tragically didn't come back.
There were many decades of neglect, but in 1990, a new generation of gardeners on the estate set about bringing these once glorious gardens back to life. With over 200,000 visitors a year, it's now one of the most popular private gardens in the country. It's constantly evolving. Chris and Angela are off to see the productive gardens, an area dedicated to fruit and vegetable cultivation, which provides seasonal produce throughout the year.
We grow all sorts, the onion crops, potatoes. The archway there is the apples, apple arch.
Lovely.
Which are all old varieties. The produce that we grow here are pre-1910 varieties. We try to keep that, so we stick to that kind of Victorian era. We've actually got some seeds that need sowing. We've got some climbing French beans that we need to do. So if you'd like to follow me,
can we go and get you
doing a practical.
All right.
Okay, thank you.
For the Victorians, gardens were a real status symbol, allowing them to show off their wealth with opulent planting schemes.
What are these then?
These are two-coloured cocoa climbing French beans.
Wow!
Now, what I want you guys to do is very simple. All we do is we just fill the pot, get the tamper, tamp it down so it's nice and level. With your finger, just up to the top of your fingernail, put two holes in.
Two. Okay.
One bean in there, one bean in there.
Great.
Okay, so what we do, just to end it, is we put a label in one of the pots. So all you need to write is two-coloured cocoa.
Great.
Job done.
In one part of the garden, the temperature is 5 degrees warmer than in other areas, which means more tropical crops can be grown, including bamboos, giant rhubarb, bananas, and incredible palm trees.
Welcome to the jungle.
Wow, yeah, you can see why they call it a jungle.
It definitely has a jungle feel.
Yeah.
Could you actually grow some of this stuff in a domestic garden?
Most of the plants that are here will grow in your garden. The further north you go, the harder it will be for some of them to grow.
Yeah. Right.
But quite a few of the plants we have here are tough.
So when we move down here, we'll be able to grow some of what you have here.
Yeah,
quite successfully.
Absolutely, yeah.
Excellent. I just love it.
Well, that's the end of the tour for Chris and Angela. Now they know how to cultivate a perfect garden for Cornwall's climate. We'd better find them a house to go with it. For our second house, we're heading towards Port Ellis, a rural village some 14 miles from Truro. And in true British style, the weather is changeable. So from basking in glorious sunshine, we're now sheltering from the rain. But that hasn't put off our buyers. It's nice, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Port Ellis Moor, it was densely populated during the Bronze Age, and again in the 18th and 19th century as well. And that's all down to the mines, especially the Bassett and Grills mine. Very prolific. And so in its heyday, this place would have had a cinema. A pub, a coachmaker.
In the Bronze Age?
No, not in the Bronze Age, in the 18th and 19th century, especially the 19th century.
Yes.
And then, of course, the mines went, and with it, the cinema, the coachmaker. But the good news is it's still got the pub, which is good news. Still got school and also a lovely church as well. But it's also the location of the second property, which could be your new house.
That sounds interesting.
Yes.
So you'll never, ever see this pub again, of course, will you, Chris?
It's marginal, marginal.
Come on, let's go and have a look at the house. Our second property is a detached cottage that was recently extended but retains a lot of its original character. Come on, don't be shy.
Wow.
Oh, yes.
It's rather lovely, isn't it?
That's smashing, yes. Oh, yes, that's very attractive.
You were nearly speechless for a second then.
Nearly.
I don't do speechless.
Not quite.
You almost did.
Close,
almost,
yeah.
Oh, that is good. That's lovely.
It's floating your boat, is it?
Mm. Yes. Yes, yeah. Love it.
What we've got here is two cottages that were around in the 1700s. Mm-hmm. That were knocked into one. 2 years ago, they put this extension on, which we'll talk about a little bit later. But you see the stone, he's handpicked all those stones from the quarry so that they match the ones on the original 1700s property.
That's lovely.
So, should we go in?
Oh, yes.
Come on, let's go. Well, there are no stony faces from Chris and Angela, so here's hoping they like this house as we step inside.
Like I'm back in the cathedral coming through this door. Come on in. Stereo Inglenooks, you've got one there and you've got one here as well, of course. Because it would have been two cottages, wouldn't
Amazing.
It?
Amazing, yes, of course. Yes.
And this is a 1950s reconditioned range.
I love it. This is quaint.
Oh, good, good.
Yes.
Right, onward and hopefully upward.
Good. Oh, yes. Good.
Great reactions, but can we keep up the momentum?
Gosh, it's a lovely kitchen. It's a smallish kitchen, but it's very nice.
You've got your boot room behind you.
Oh, yes.
It's a boot room with a view.
Hey, that's great.
And it's very nicely done.
It's immaculate, isn't it? Yeah,
very nice. Yeah. It looks nearly brand new, actually. Yeah.
With the exposed stone as well.
Yeah,
it's all around you.
It's fab.
OK, let's go upstairs.
Our buyers seem to have really warm feelings about this property. Time now to check out the first floor.
So in this part of the house, you've got a good-sized bedroom there.
Uh-huh.
Lovely little office space here.
That's super.
Good-sized family bathroom.
Nice bathroom.
And another room here. Again, the current owner is doing a bit of work.
Yes, I see.
Lovely window, though, isn't it?
It is.
And that stone again.
I know. Yeah. Masses of it. Good Lord.
Yeah. What do you think of this room?
It's big enough, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
It's just so quirky. It's so interesting.
You've also got an ensuite.
Oh. Well, that's good.
You don't expect it to be there, really, do you?
No, you don't. That's ever so good.
Yeah. So, can you see yourselves here?
It's super. Yeah.
Yeah.
I love it.
I could. Where are we going to put all your clothes?
Oh, well, think about that.
Of course, you could just keep all your clothes in here and you'd be in the master bedroom.
This isn't, then?
It isn't the master bedroom.
Oh,
if it's a master bedroom you're after, yeah. Check this out.
That fooled them. Well, what have we got in store?
This is what you call a master bedroom.
Oh!
Goodness me!
Oh, that's gorgeous!
It is, isn't it? Wow!
Love it! It's fabulous.
Isn't it, Jace? Just great, isn't it?
Yeah. It's fabulous.
Imagine yourself sitting in those seats.
Yes.
Looking out at your gorgeous view.
I'm imagining.
Yeah.
This is really impressive, isn't it?
It's lovely. Amazing, and the vaulted ceiling and... Oh, it's gorgeous.
And there's one other thing as well.
What?
Your ensuite as well. Very modern.
Oh, yes. That's marvellous. Fabulous.
It's fantastic.
Should we pop out to the garden?
Yes.
Talk money, come on.
Well, Chris and Angela are already dreaming about moving in, but before I bring them back down to earth with the price, let's take a look at the garden, which has the most spectacular views.
Come on out. This gives you a good view of the house and the Calvadonnach cairn as well. Unspoilt, beautiful.
It is.
You've also got a bit of garden the other side of the property as well.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And actually, cellar space running underneath the whole part of the extension.
Right, yes. Really? I noticed that. I knew there was, because there's a door at the back into it.
There is,
it.
Yeah.
So cellar space.
Well done,
as well.
Super sleuth.
Yes,
super sleuth,
there you go. Yeah.
Lots of storage.
Yes.
Right, let's talk money, shall we?
Oh, OK.
Who's going first this time?
Angela.
Oh, okay. Such a coward.
Dead right.
Yeah.
375,000.
Okay. I'd be somewhere near that, but I'm trying to think of reasons to come in less. And I can't think of one, so I'll say 375 as well, I'm afraid.
375,000 as well.
Yeah.
You're both close. Mm. It's on the market for £380,000.
Uh-huh.
But. The owners are open to offers.
Right.
It depends how much you like it.
Well, that we'll have to talk about.
Yes.
Well, listen, I think the rain's on its way, so I think you should get yourselves indoors, have another look around. Go on.
OK.
Take your time.
Thank you.
Okay, I don't mind getting wet.
You're dry.
She doesn't mean it.
Although it's over budget at £380,000, this beautiful cottage could be in reach with a sensible offer. It gives them a lovely country kitchen. a quirky living room with exposed stone and inglenook fireplace. Four bedrooms, including a sensational master bedroom with ensuite, and great views.
These are a smashing idea, aren't they? These little window seats. Yes.
Yeah. I mean, the whole thing's been done very, very well.
So clever.
The main living room was wonderful. It had everything that my wife's ever wanted. It had a multi-fuel burner in one end and a range in the other. And it's just, it's a very intriguing, original space. I've never quite seen anything the same before.
It's so interesting and so cleverly done. If we think longer and harder about it, there are things that aren't absolutely perfect. What is? But it's lovely.
For your information, it didn't rain.
Oh.
There you go.
Shucks.
Yeah. Try harder next time.
Yes, I'll pray. My prayers weren't answered.
Tell you what, you're in there long enough, though.
Yeah.
And you're smiling, which is a good thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you've seen two, quite different properties. So let's not even discuss them anymore, OK? We'll reconvene in the morning, and I'll drive you back now. Is that?
Smashing.
Come on.
Yes.
As the evening draws to a close over Cornwall, our buyers take a moment to mull over a busy day of house hunting. Scuba diving enthusiast Chris and his leading lady wife Angela are taking the property plunge with a move from Altrincham in Cheshire to Cornwall. So far, they thought our first property was blooming marvellous with its perfect-sized garden. But then they were completely captivated by the rustic charm of our second house, with its breathtaking views. Coming up, will the mystery house fill them with joy or leave them feeling empty?
Nobody's lived in it.
Nobody's lived in it.
Ooh.
And I come face to face with some infamous Cornish claws.
You ever been got by one of those pinchers?
No, not recently.
It's day two in our quest to find the lovely Christopher and Angela, their dream property here in Cornwall. And I must say, it's going rather well. They seem to like aspects of both properties yesterday, especially the second house. Mind you, who wouldn't want to wake up in that master bedroom? Absolutely divine. They're after lots of space, especially in the kitchen area. And I have to be honest, you're not really going to get that in a Cornish cottage. But you get it in a new build. Except they said they didn't like new builds. They didn't mean that, did they? It's time to find out with a mystery property.
As we head towards the mystery house, I want to see how our buyers are feeling about their search.
What are your thoughts on the two properties?
I've sort of forgotten the first one because my mind is full of the second one.
Right.
And parts of it were absolutely fabulous.
So the mystery property, what would you like it to be?
We like it to look nice outside, but it's more what it's like inside, because we're going to be living inside it.
Bring on the small, dark Cornish cottage with no utility room or view, yeah?
Yeah, that'll do, yes, no problem.
Yeah, right.
For the mystery property, we're taking Chris and Angela right to the edge of their search area, to the outskirts of Helston, which is about 18 miles from Truro. This bustling old market town lies at the edge of the Lizard Peninsula and was inhabited in the 6th century by the Saxons. The patron saint of Helston, and indeed Cornwall, is Saint Michael. And there's a church here in his honour that dominates the town's skyline. Our mystery house is a bit of a gamble, a brand new build, perhaps not the obvious choice for a couple who profess not to be keen on modern houses. However, its location is perfect for the community they're after, and their much sought-after country views.
So you've got your bearings, I take it. Just up the lane we've walked down is Helston. So that's got your supermarket, your cinema, your pub,
so,
everything you need.
Everything we need.
And the reason I've stopped here is because this is the mystery property.
Ooh.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Mm.
Very interesting. Wow.
Wow.
It is new.
It is new.
Yeah. I quite like that, actually.
Yes, I do, actually.
Yeah, I do.
Is it a brand new build?
Yep, brand new build.
Nobody's lived in it?
Nobody's lived in it.
Ooh.
And the current owners described this area where the house is in as the Beverly Hills of Helston.
You're kidding.
Yeah, so I thought maybe you'd like that, you know.
maybe a little bit.
You mean I'm ready for my...
Yes, well, exactly. Exactly. You've been waiting all your life to say that, haven't you?
Yes.
Should we go in?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Come on, let's go.
I think you call that a risk worth taking. A fabulous reaction from Chris and Angela. Let's hope the inside dazzles them too.
Come on in. Nice bright hallway.
Very nice.
Very modern. Underfloor heating throughout, down here and upstairs as well.
That's great. No radiators?
Nope, no radiators.
Super.
No radiators, but our buyers are definitely getting hot under the collar with this contemporary home.
So, again, very modern kitchen.
Oh, yes.
It's great. I love it.
Yeah?
Yeah. That is beautiful. Amazing.
Lots of storage, great oak surfaces.
Beautiful.
And this lovely little breakfast bar as well.
Oh,
it's
great.
It really is.
Oh, it's fab.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It is amazing.
I mean, it's obviously modern and smart.
It is very modern,
streamlined,
yeah.
And I'll buy that.
Excellent. And you're probably noticing that there's nowhere to put your plugs. And this is for your plugs.
So clever. And the little
skirting
lights.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, let me show you the living room.
Okay. Oh.
You've got your wood burner.
I know.
Oh, yes.
And look at the view.
Fantastic.
That's beautiful.
Yeah. Do you know our furniture would fit in here with no problem?
It would.
Yeah, we wouldn't have to throw anything away.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just spot on.
It's super.
Well, you've seen downstairs. Should we go upstairs?
Yes,
oh, yes,
please.
Okay, let me dive through you.
Fabulous. Thank you.
Also on this floor is a utility room and cloakroom. But let's see what they make of the first floor. Up here, there are three double bedrooms and a fabulous bathroom with a freestanding bath, where they can enjoy a long, hot soak looking out over the Cornish countryside. But it's time to see their room.
So this is the master bedroom.
Oh. That's a lovely size.
It is.
It?
It's fine, but
I love the roof like that as well.
I like the roof.
Yeah, fantastic.
I mean, it's fabulous. And look at the views again.
Of course, there's another room through there. What would you like it to be?
I bet it's an ensuite, but I'd like it to be a dressing room.
It's an ensuite, but okay. It's a really impressive
Is
ensuite.
It?
Yeah. It's a pretty impressive ensuite, isn't it?
Yeah.
I love this bath as well with the waterfall
I do.
Tap.
It's beautiful.
Absolutely amazing.
Beautiful.
Brilliant.
Oh, it's fab.
It is.
It's a good ensuite, isn't it?
Absolutely
it is,
amazing,
and two smashing
yeah.
velux.
Yeah.
You can
very bright again.
Lovely
it's really
light again.
Well, that, hasn't it?
It's absolutely beautiful.
Good.
Yes.
Well, I think we should head outside.
Okay.
We can talk money.
Oh, after you.
Thank you.
Within the grounds of this property, there's a garage and plenty of space for parking, which I know was important to Chris. But I'm not sure how they're going to react to the size of the garden.
Well, dare I say, it's not the biggest plot of land.
No.
No.
Manageable.
Very much so.
Mm.
Yeah.
Too small for you?
What do you think?
No, it's fine. It needs... We have to think about it. We could put a trellis along there and grow fruit or whatever there.
Maybe veg at the end?
I don't think veg. Too small for veg.
No, maybe not.
Yeah.
No.
And you are very much part of the community here, you know, as you are surrounded by houses,
but
you wanted that, didn't you, really?
Sort of. You're separate enough, but we didn't want to be too out of the way.
OK. Well, can you afford it?
I don't know.
Should find out.
Mm.
And what do you reckon it's on the market for?
Oi, oi, oi.
Go on, Chris, you go first.
I mean, I would say... 365.
OK. £365,000.
Mm. Well, did you say Beverly Hills?
Oh, yeah, the Beverly Hills of the area. Yeah.
385?
£385,000. It's currently on the market for £365,000. What do you reckon? It's within budget.
Yes, it is.
I think it needs very serious thinking about
it, actually.
Yes, I do, actually. Because it's got a lot positive as well as a few negatives.
OK. Yeah. Well, go back in. Have a look round.
Thank you.
Imagine yourself in that kitchen.
Yes.
No, she'll imagine me in the kitchen, actually.
Go on, off you go.
OK.
This ultra-modern house is priced at £365,000, so it's within budget. And I think it's really caught the imagination of Chris and Angela. It has a fabulous fitted kitchen with breakfast bar, a master bedroom with stunning ensuite. It's on the edge of a village, and it has lovely views of the surrounding hills.
It's very nice.
It is, isn't it?
Mm. I like the lighting.
Yeah. That's a fabulous view.
It is, isn't it?
The mystery house is very different, but it's lovely. I love the fact that it's so simple and clean lines. Everything is fitted beautifully. Obviously, the kitchen is fabulous.
From the outside, I think it looks superb. A lot of thought's gone into it. The design on its own is absolutely super right the way through it. Underfloor heating, for a start, you know, that's very effective and something that's virtually maintenance-free.
I think they weren't too keen on modern properties. They've been in there a while. Here they come. Seen enough for now?
Yes, I think so.
OK. Well, three very different properties, so I think we should retire somewhere and have a good chat about them.
OK,
what a good idea.
Come on.
All along Cornwall's coastline, the harbours and villages are a constant reminder of the county's strong fishing heritage. 95% of Cornwall's shellfish catch is caught in the seas around North Cornwall, with harbours like Newquay playing a vital role. It's home to the largest shellfishing fleet on this stretch of coast, and is mainly made up of small boats using the traditional pot-hauling method. Skipper Phil Treblecock has fished here for over 40 years, and has kindly agreed for me to join him on his morning trip out to sea.
Thanks so much for taking me out today. What a day for it.
It is, just right, isn't it?
So, Phil, what are we actually going to be doing today?
Well, we're getting all 100 pots and get a few spiders and a few lobsters, hopefully.
100 pots? Whoa! So, you know, in a typical day, how many spider crabs do you catch?
Well, we have been only a bit under a kilo, but I think they come on in abundance now, so I think they'll be a good season.
And do you eat them?
Yeah, I love them.
Fantastic. Should we go aboard?
Yeah, let's go.
Catching shellfish using these small-scale inshore boats is widely viewed as one of the most sustainable and environmentally friendly ways of fishing. The boats go out for a few hours at a time, and the seabed and marine life are largely undisturbed by the pots as they're hauled in.
So how long has this pot been down for, Phil?
3 nights.
How do you feel when you're out here doing this?
Well, look, this is your office, look at that lot.
It's amazing, isn't it? The best of nature.
A bad day in here is better than a good day in the office, they say.
The shell fisheries around Cornwall's coast are seasonal, usually starting to set pots from early spring until late in the autumn. This helps to protect the stocks and the fishermen from the rough winter seas.
Anything in this one?
Plenty of spider crabs. There's a better crab here.
Oh, that's a good size.
But you see with that, you see the crab, see how pale he's looking?
Yeah.
He's too pale, like he's white, he hadn't long cast his shell. So there's no meat in that.
Right.
And if you just press in the side of the shell...
Gotcha.
..he's a bit soft. So we let him go and we'll catch him in a month's time.
Have you ever been got by one of those pinchers?
No, not recently.
Yeah, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would do, yeah.
Cornish crab and lobster are protected by laws set by the Cornwall Sea Fisheries Committee, making it illegal to land shellfish that are too young or too small. Immature shellfish are returned unharmed to the sea to grow further.
So we're... specifically fishing for spider crabs now, yeah?
Yeah, just here, it's on the sand. The spider crabs like the sand. See how many's in there, look?
Oh, my God. Loads.
There's a big male here, look.
OK. Wow, that's massive.
Yeah. See, the meat is in the claws.
Yep. And in the body.
Yeah, and in the body. People think there's no meat in the body, but that's like a honeycomb in there. It's all full of, like, little holes, and you pick the meat out.
Right.
You've got to sit down... nice bit of bread, glass of wine. Take your time and enjoy the local produce.
Any chance we could go into shore and have a try?
Go in and try one, shall we?
Yeah, let's do that.
Right.
Brilliant.
Well, I may have woken up feeling a bit crabby, but all that sea air has given me an appetite, and I'm really looking forward to tucking in to what we've caught.
Well, cheers. Thanks.
All right.
That was brilliant. All enjoyed it. This is what it's all about.
Yeah.
So this is spider crab.
Yeah. All things good aren't always in heaven.
True.
That is what you call heaven. That is a doorstep spider crab sandwich.
The crab's a lot sweeter than
it is.
It's
lovely.
Crab.
You think out of this humble creature here,
yeah.
That's the meat that comes out of it.
Mm. Mm. It's beautiful. Absolutely lovely. Well, listen, I've loved it. Thanks so much for giving up your time and taking me out there as well.
Been a pleasure.
All the best to you. Thanks, mate.
Well on.
Well, I really enjoyed that, and I really do think I've got a future as a crab and lobster fisherman. Or am I just a giving it all that. Sorry. Let's find out if Chris and Angela have liked any of the properties that we've shown them. Sitting here, looking out at that, I can understand why you want to move to Cornwall.
It's
absolutely
really,
brilliant.
Yeah, amazing.
The question is, have we found somewhere that you really want to move to? Let's talk about the first property that we saw.
It was very pretty from the outside, a fabulous garden.
Yeah.
The downstairs was nice. It was nice. The kitchen could have been a bit bigger, I think, but the bedrooms were just too small.
It
wasn't.
For you.
It wasn't for me.
No, not really.
It wasn't for you, so therefore
it wasn't
for you.
No, absolutely true.
Yeah. We talk about bedrooms. Then property two had a rather nice one, didn't it?
That was amazing.
The star feature of the property was that bedroom.
Yeah.
And it wasn't just a bedroom, that's the thing. I think that does it down, actually, calling it a bedroom. It was the area where you would sit in the two tub chairs looking out through that window. Oh.
The whole house was really nicely done, I thought.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it was.
Absolutely beautiful.
Only one thing, really, for me.
I know what you're going to say.
I mean, it was the drive to it.
What was wrong with that?
It's really very narrow in places. Because we've got to bear in mind that maybe the driving will get more difficult as we get older, you know.
Yeah.
It was a little bit too far out, that's all. I would like to be sort of a bit more in a community.
Right. And the mystery property, you know, a new build. Mm-hmm. And you liked it.
Yeah. Well, that was a surprise. It was a mystery, as I asked for. No.
It definitely was part of a community.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Had the stunning views. Absolutely fabulous. It had the wood burner.
Yeah.
And lovely kitchen. Beautifully done with all mod cons. A smallish garden.
Yeah.
But you can't have it all.
No, you can't.
It was pretty damn good.
So it sounds to me like you might go back and see it?
I think we will.
I don't think there's any doubt. Yes, we will.
Fantastic. Wow.
Yeah.
So you could have found your house.
We could have
done. Yeah.
Well, listen, I hope you do find your perfect property here in Cornwall.
You.
It's been really fun sharing a couple of days with you.
Thank you.
Really nice to meet you both.
Thank you.
Thank
it's
you
been lovely.
Much.
Pleasure. Well, that was a bit of a turn up for the books, wasn't it? I thought we had it in the bag with that second property and the gorgeous bedroom. But Chris and Angela seem really taken by the modern mystery property. What a dramatic turnaround. But I suppose we'd expect nothing else with Angela's love of the theatre, darling. And I suppose it just goes to show that you don't really know what you want until you see it. I'll tell you what I want to get in and out of this wind. We'll see you next time on Escape to the Country. Chris and Angela hot-footed it straight back to Helston to take another look at the mystery house. However, after a lot of thought, they decided that some of the rooms in the property were too small for them. The good news, though, is that they've found a house in Cornwall and are moving in very soon. If you'd like to escape to the country in Scotland, Wales, Northern Ireland or England and need our help, please apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.